80% of adults in Great Britain only left their homes for the permitted reasons, if at all. 91% of adults avoided contact with vulnerable people, and compared with 12% last year, 44% of employed adults worked from home in that period. So you can see that there have been very dramatic and very important changes that the British people have made that have contributed to where we are now in terms of being able to begin easing the social distancing restrictions that we've been under for so many weeks. Next slide, please. Now, this slide shows you in a bit more detail testing and new cases across the UK from the period 6th of April on the left of the graphs through to the 14th of May on the right. And the top array in pink is testing. Please bear in mind that some people, a very small proportion, will have been tested more than once. But nevertheless, on the 14th of May, 126,000 tests were recorded, were performed. This is a new record. It's goes on the back of over 2.2 million tests delivered in total. And in terms of confirmed cases, on the 14th of May, there were 3,446 confirmed cases against a total of 233,151. If you look carefully at the bottom graph, the green graph, you can now see a gradual downward trend in the number of confirmed cases. Next slide, please. These are new data again, recently published by the Office for National Statistics, based upon a survey of households that will eventually get to a total size of 10,000 households surveyed. What it shows you are data from the 27th of April through to the 10th of May. And these are estimates based upon the sample, but these are estimates for all of England. And the estimate is that in that time period, 148,000...
It's 23 hours.
..people were infected with COVID-19. That is 0.27% of the English population, which is just under 3 people infected in every 1,000. So that is really now quite a low level of infection in the community that is being picked up through this survey. And this survey will be repeated regularly. Over time, it's going to be able to show us regional trends and regional data, and the data will feed into the Joint Biosecurity Centre to help us keep a very close eye on COVID-19 as we move forwards. Next slide, please. I'm turning now to the data from hospitals. The upper curve shows new daily admissions from the 24th of March through to the 12th of May. The bottom curve shows the percentage of critical care beds occupied by COVID-19 patients. And there are 4 traces there covering the 5 traces, I beg your pardon, covering 4 traces covering the 4 nations of the UK. What you can see on both of those slides are now long, steady declines in admissions and the proportion of critical care beds occupied by COVID-19 patients. This is clearly extremely good news and shows that the pressure on hospitals is now beginning to ease. Over the page, please. Thank you. This further data shows the total number of people in hospital with COVID-19 across the UK. And the general pattern across the UK, you can see now, is clearly downwards. There's been a 14% drop in the total number of people in hospital since last week. And again, this is moving in the right direction. Next slide, please. This slide sadly shows deaths due to COVID-19. confirmed with a positive test right across the UK, beginning at the 14th of March on the left of the slide and moving to the 14th of May. And there have been 428 deaths with a confirmed test reported on the 14th of May. But as importantly now, if you look at the slide itself and look at the yellow curve picking out the 7-day rolling average, this decline is now continuing and it is sustained, which again is a very positive sign indeed. Thank you, Secretary.
Thank you very much, John.